Welcome to this introduction to the growing integrated circuit temperature problem and how you can enable your circuit simulator with accurate temperature data. According to this special report published recently in the proceedings of the IEEE, heating and thermal management are among the key factors limiting the performance of future integrated circuits, accelerating electromigration and oxide breakdown, which are both exponentially dependent on temperature, and necessitating thermally aware design and aggressive thermal management. There's no mystery why this problem is getting worse every day. Chip-scale IC packages make many compromises to achieve their small size, including shaving the heat-conducting die and eliminating the copper lead frame and heat spreader bar. With power transistors and packages like these driving motors and other high-current loads, is it any wonder that temperature problems occur? Your circuit simulation may produce significant errors if you assume the whole design is at a single constant temperature. The reality is that dynamic temperature variations of 25 degrees Celsius or more inside the chip are routine. Even differences of a few degrees can degrade the performance of a precision-matched circuit. These temperature differences can result in unanticipated behavior or device failure. If your chip has multiple heat sources, then together these will create a very complex temperature profile with many peaks and valleys. Here's a typical SoC layout with a number of power transistors surrounded by digital and analog circuits. Of course, the analog circuits are quite sensitive to temperature, with many matched devices that are assumed to be at equal temperatures at all times. Let's watch the temperature while the chip is in operation. We'll use an oblique view with the temperature represented by the color and shape of the 3D surface above the layout. Watch the temperature rise and fall as the power transistors are activated. The shape of the temperature surface indicates the different temperatures at different parts of the layout. The peaks shown here are temperature hotspots that are 15 degrees hotter than the surrounding circuitry, which may cause reliability issues. If you need matching between devices, temperature differences like these may cause problems on your chip. Of course, these temperatures vary over time, often very quickly. This makes temperature hotspots and differences even tougher to predict. Circuit simulators like Spectre, HSPICE, and ELDO accept a distinct temperature for each device, but designers do not have this data. Most designers use a constant temperature in circuit simulation, which leads to incorrect simulation results. Here we see some power waveforms for several devices on a chip. They consist of sinusoidal components on top of DC components. Now let's take a look at the simulated temperature waveforms of these devices. The millisecond scale power variations result in a fluctuating ramp up in temperature. These waveforms show a distinct, time-varying temperature for each device. This is quite different from the constant, uniform temperature which is typically used in circuit simulation. You can make your circuit simulation temperature accurate by annotating a distinct temperature waveform for each device into your circuit simulation. Designers can leverage temperature-enabled simulation to improve design quality and make their designs more robust while avoiding costly design respins. Thank you for watching this video.